Toyota is hard at work in its research and development lab on something brand new. You've probably heard that the hydrogen-powered Toyota vehicle that runs on fuel cells to generate power has finally been released. Toyota has developed something utterly unique at this point. They are referring to it as the hydrogen combustion engine of the future. This technology has the potential to revolutionize the automotive sector completely. So, what's different about Toyota's new engine, and how is it set to revolutionize the automotive sector? Toyota is pursuing a different approach than other automakers who have transitioned entirely to electric vehicles. However, being unique is not the only factor at play here. It is also about improving oneself. The precarious state of the planet is common knowledge at this point. In addition, research conducted by globalcitizen.org found that the transportation sector was accountable for a staggering 15% of the world's total carbon emissions. And it should not come as a surprise that conventional internal combustion engines have been a significant factor in escalating the pollution crisis. And while electric cars are undeniably becoming more well-liked, some might argue that they are not the only solution. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe and has the highest specific energy density of any non-nuclear power source. It is also possible to produce it using various sources, store it indefinitely, and transport it easily. In addition, it does not produce any harmful emissions. Every year, millions of metric tons of hydrogen are created and used without any problems whatsoever. In addition, it is already being used as a source of electricity in various applications, including buildings, ships, and trains. Unlike BEVs, cars that use hydrogen have longer ranges, they don't need to be recharged like electric cars, and the only product that comes out of the exhaust pipe is water. That's correct, there aren't any pollutants here. At this point, you might be asking what automotive manufacturers are doing with all this information. Every hydrogen engine uses a fuel cell, which is responsible for converting hydrogen into power. It's also like magic, but based on scientific principles that many manufacturers have been unable to crack. However, one company has been ahead of the pack since 1997. When Toyota initially introduced the Prius, the company started reducing the number of vehicles it produced that were fueled by fossil fuels. They have been riding the environmentally conscious bandwagon for some time now. However, they are not the only ones doing it. Automakers from all over the world are collaborating on the development of ecologically friendly vehicles that are powered by hydrogen, electricity, and solar energy. It's not just about preventing the destruction of the environment. The provision of energy security, the enhancement of air quality, and the reduction of environmental effects are the primary goals. After it has been produced, hydrogen can be distributed in a productive and economical manner. Electrolysis, which utilizes 100% renewable excess energy, is the method that is used at the vast majority of hydrogen refueling stations. These stations require only water and electricity to function. Power is provided either through environmentally friendly tariffs or, at certain stations, directly from solar or wind generators located on the premises. Recently, Toyota has asserted that it has developed a novel technique for harnessing the power of hydrogen. Their research and development division recently displayed a new concept vehicle, the Corolla Cross H2, equipped with a hydrogen combustion engine. The idea of using hydrogen to drive an internal combustion engine is not novel. Nonetheless, Toyota has been hard at work developing a new vehicle that uses a hydrogen combustion engine rather than the hydrogen fuel cell technology that powers the Toyota Mirai, the company's previous hydrogen-powered vehicle. One of the first companies to enter the market was BMW, a German carmaker, which presented the 750 HL in 2002, and then the Hydrogen 7 in 2005. The Hydrogen 7, produced by BMW, was derived from a conventional gasoline-powered 6-litre V12 engine, but with some adjustments to allow hydrogen combustion in addition to gasoline. It was a dual-fuel engine, and to make it even more awesome, there have only ever been produced a total of 100 of these nasty boys. However, it is plagued with some of the most serious drawbacks. To begin with, it had a very high risk of catching fire. Additionally, hydrogen was and is still difficult to process and store, which can be a bit of a hassle. Furthermore, let's not forget the nitrous oxide emitted during combustion. Even though it may not be as dangerous as carbon monoxide, the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, still considers it a pollutant. This was where Toyota saw an opportunity. Toyota believed that there are many ways to solve pollution. Therefore, investments need to be made in every field to satisfy the short-term, medium-term, and long-term requirements of people worldwide. And this is where the use of hydrogen comes in, which will play a significant role in Toyota's Beyond Zero campaign, which the company plans to carry out with their H2 vehicles. It also appears to be the direction that automotive technology will be heading in the future. But how exactly does this technology work? The GR Corolla H2 has a turbocharged 1.6 litres three-cylinder engine that runs on hydrogen instead of gasoline. With just 5 kilograms of hydrogen, the car can be driven up to 300 miles and it only emits water. Toyota uses thick armoured fuel tanks to store the highly flammable hydrogen technology they picked up from their Mirai. In addition, Toyota has collaborated with Yamaha Motor to develop a hydrogen-fueled V8 engine. This engine will generate 455 horsepower and 398 pound-feet of torque. But the real showstopper is the 8-into-1 top-mounted exhaust manifold that will produce a distinctive high-frequency sound. And if that weren't enough, hydrogen-powered cars have a greater range than electric vehicles while having a shorter amount of time required to refuel. You just need 2 minutes to refuel the GR Corolla H2. Additionally, it reduces the requirement for materials like lithium and nickel, which are utilized in producing battery packs. Consequently, the GR Corolla H2 is something that you should definitely keep an eye on, regardless of whether you are a gearhead or just someone who loves cutting-edge technology. And considering that testing in the real world has already begun, it won't be long before we see these automobiles out on the road. And when it does, forget all you know about electric cars, since the Toyota hydrogen combustion engine has several benefits over them. The GR Corolla H2 concept car is currently undergoing real-world evaluation as well as testing under winter road conditions. And because the Japanese government has such great aspirations for hydrogen, they intend to have 200,000 hydrogen-driven vehicles on the road by 2025 and 800,000 by 2030, in addition to expanding the number of refueling stations across the country. Now, let's discuss the sound, shall we? Not only does it have an amazing sound, but the exhaust system is identical to that of a gasoline-powered car. And because it does not use any fossil fuels, Toyota's unique hydrogen engine will release no carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. You might be wondering, but what about safety? Toyota has that aspect covered. Toyota has strengthened the connecting rods, reworked the valves, and tightened the valve seats and fuel injectors that work with gas rather than liquids so that you can ride confidently, knowing that safety is the most important aspect. The BZ4X, the company's first fully battery electric vehicle, BEV, only sold a few hundred units by October 2022, and the company does not intend to increase production of that vehicle until 2025. According to experts, even though sales of battery electrics have undoubtedly surpassed sales of H2 cars by a significant margin, these vehicles still only account for a relatively small portion of the overall market for new cars. The press has frequently criticized Toyota for its decision to spend on research and development on hydrogen rather than fully committing to the development of battery electric vehicles. However, it appears that all of their hard work is paying off. Even the most ardent supporters of battery electric vehicles concede that hydrogen-fueled cars may be a better option for long-distance hauling. Trucks can refuel more quickly, which helps maximize the all-important amount of time they are operational, and because they are lighter, they can carry more freight. The hydrogen combustion engine that Toyota has developed offers several benefits, some of which are superior to what electric vehicles can provide. Even though fuel cell-powered hydrogen cars are already on the market and more are being developed, adding hydrogen combustion engines will give automakers and drivers a new technological choice. As the demand for power rises and the price of environmentally friendly hydrogen continues to drop, many industry experts feel that this type of vehicle with zero or reduced carbon emissions could soon have its time, while electric vehicles may soon reach their peak demand. That's all from this video. Do you think Toyota has any chance with its hydrogen-fueled cars against the formidable Tesla? Please let us know in the comments section. See you at the next one and stay safe. Peace.